Hello everyone, welcome to the first episode of HVAC Education Hub Channel. This first part will be basic, heat loss calculation, how to deal with heat loss in building. Regarding building heat loss calculation, there are a few important parts to take care of. First one is temperature differential. This is the difference between desired internal temperature in our building, in our room, and the lowest external temperature, usually known as design temperature. So in this example, if we want inside temperature of 22 degrees Celsius, design outdoor temperature is minus 12 degrees Celsius, this temperature differential is 34 degrees Celsius or degrees Kelvin. You need to take care of when you are dealing with Kelvin, as 1 Kelvin is minus 272.15 degrees Celsius, but here we are dealing with temperature difference. So temperature difference is the same in Kelvin and Celsius. Another point is surface areas in square meter. So this is surface area of our wall, floor, ceiling or windows. In this example or in this photo, you can see how heat loss is distributed through the building. So 35% is going through the ceiling or the roof, 25% through the walls, 15% through the ground, 15% through the door, and 10% through the windows. And third part is Uvalue. Uvalue is the rate of transfer of heat through a structure, and this is in watt per square meter and Kelvin. On next slide, I will go more detail in Uvalue. And when we put everything together, we have building heat loss, Q in watts. So building heat loss is U multiplied with A multiplied with delta T. Or in easy and understandable way, this is how much joule of heat per second, so this is watt, building requires to maintain an internal temperature, for example 22 degrees, when it's minus 12 degrees outside. So we need to know that this is speed, so heat is speed, how much joule of heat per second. And on later slide we will go more deep inside. As I mentioned, I will now go much deep inside Uvalue. So in short, the smaller the U-value, the lower the heat flow through the component is. Here on table and on this photo, you can see examples of some materials. So for example, if this is single glazed windows, U-value is 5.2 watt per square meter and Kelvin. And if we have double glazed windows, it's lower. For triple glazed windows, it's even lower. The same applies for roofs, walls and floors. So with poor insulated roof, we have 1 watt per square meter and Kelvin, and for well insulated, we have 0.25. What this means? So it means that for each Kelvin of temperature difference through the sum material, so for 1 square meter, we have, for example, for single glazed windows, 5.2 watt per square meter and Kelvin heat loss. So for 1 square meter of single glazed windows, 5.2 multiplied with 20, if we have difference of 20 degrees Kelvin, like inside is 20 and outside is 0, we have 104 watts per square meter heat loss through this window. And if our window is 2 square meter, multiplied with 2, and we have 208. So regarding this example, like heat loss per square meter, this is important if we want to calculate roughly how much heat loss we have in some room or in some building. So this is building heat loss per square meter. And then we remove surface, and we have only U value and delta T. So, if our U value is high and our delta T is high, then our building heat loss will also be high. For example, if our U value is 5 watts per square meter and our delta T is 30 Kelvin, for example, inside is 20 degrees, outside is minus 10, we have 150 watts per square meter heat loss in that building. Another example, if our U value is lower, delta T is high, then our heat loss is lower. For example, if our U value is 50% less, for example 2.5 watts per square meter, and our delta T is the same, like 30 Kelvin, then our heat loss is only 75 watts per square meter. So 50% lower U value, 50% lower our heat loss. And ideal example is if we have low U value and low delta T, our building heat loss is even lower. For example, U value is 2.5 watts per square meter, delta T is 15 Kelvin, so typical autumn cold day, like outside is 5 degrees, inside is 20 degrees, we have only 37.5 watts per square meter heat loss in that building. So it is important to remember that heat loss is not the same for every day and for every hour. This means if it's the coldest day, heat loss is the biggest. If the day is not so cold, heat loss is lower. We cannot interfere on delta T because it depends where we live, if it's a cold city or not so cold city, but we can interfere on U value. So it means if our building is well insulated, if our walls are good, our windows are good, then our heat loss is not so big. This is all for today. Thank you for watching. Hit subscribe button and see you later.